will sing a Flumley Kettlewell, a Yorkshire man of fame. Near Bolton firstly he was born, and there he made his fame. Although a wealthy farmer's son, possessed of health most rude, he spent his whole life trying to prove that no bugger needed food. In spite of Flumley Kettlewell and all he had to say, it seems that man was born to eat until his dying day.
You may think that it's funny, or consider him berserk, but think of the advantages if Flumley's theory works. Goodbye to indigestion, adieu to diarrhea. A little abdominal emptiness is all you'd have to fear.
In spite of Flumley Kettlewell and all he had to say, it seems that man was born to eat until his dying day. Now the strictest of experiments he ate, he carried through, because he starved the horse, he starved the dog, and he starved the donkey too, to cure their dreadful habits of eating between gaps. And when success was in his grips, the poor beast just collapsed. And so, in spite of Flumley Kettlewell and all he had to say, it seems that man was born to eat until his dying day.
He thought and food is evil, he disdained a good square meal. Plates of chips and Yorkshire puds to him held no appeal. He practiced and he practiced to perfect the food-free day. Just when he'd perfected it, the poor sod passed away.
In spite of Flumley Kettlewell and all he had to say, it seems that man was born to eat until his dying day. So when the final trumpets blow and mortals bow down low to those great men of science who have taught us all we know, with Einstein, Pasteur, Curie too, let Flumley take his seat. His failure proves the truth of truths, you die unless you eat. And so, in spite of Flumley Kettlewell and all he had to say, it seems that man was born to eat until his dying day. Again, in spite of Flumley Kettlewell and all he had to say, it seems that man was born to eat until his dying day.